last couple of games, but defensively we've been solid, we've been tough enough. You know, they mirror us in a lot of ways with their size, the way that they're going to attack from the perimeter. They have really good guards. You know, Whitehead's playing, you know, as well as any guard in the league. So we're going to have to defend a lot of ball screens, you know, similar to the last game at Creighton. And we're going to, hopefully, we're going to have to make some shots.
Yeah, how is it that you bounced back from a game where you weren't making a lot of shots?
You know, prior to those two games, the last two games, we were in the 80s. You know, we had 50 points the last game and 64. You know, we got to get guys, you know, really making shots, having confidence. You know, we were getting wide open shots. We just got to make them. I thought the last couple of teams did a great job of keeping us out of our transition, which is a big part of our offense. We like to score. We like to get out and, you know, get to the rim. And they've been doing a good job of keeping us from doing that.
We've had some dry spells since the Big East has started, pretty much in every game. Is that just because it's the Big East, or it's just something that you need to correct?
It's because it's the Big East. You know, every night, you know, you're scouted well. You know, it's just a very tough league from top to bottom. Every night, you know, we're playing against different schemes and defensive strategies to, you know, to limit us. And to our credit, you know, Chris, I mean, he gets a lot of attention, especially in ball screens. And he still wills himself, you know, to the rim, you know, make big shots. And, you know, we're just going to have to, you know, continue to prepare, execute sharp, make our free throws. That would help a lot, too. And get some stops on the defensive end so we can get some runouts.
You mentioned the ball screen. How much, you guys, you're on that a lot. How much knowledge does that help you when facing a team like Seton Hall or even a Creighton, like knowing that they like to do that as well, given that you guys like to do that as well? How much of that kind of helps you out just a little bit?
It always helps, knowing that we play a ball screen, you know, predominant attack on offense. But it all comes down to personnel. You know, we know his tendencies. He's a big-time guard. You know, they have a couple of them. They're two leading scorers, both averaging, you know, I think in the league 15 and maybe 14. And they have a big guy, you know, Delgado in the post that, you know, when they run that 1-5 ball screen, you know, he can roll to the basket. So we're gonna mix it up. We don't give a steady diet of any way that we particularly play the ball screen defense. Yep. So we're going to mix it up.
You know, obviously, just talk about Coach Cool even. You know, how much important is it, like, delegation at this point and trying to keep things, like, as status quo as possible for the guys?
It's very important. You know, our preparation it has to be really solid and tight. You know, so we try to keep it as normal as possible under the circumstances. You know, obviously, you know, him being under the weather, he's not as physically present, but we're constantly on in meetings and, you know, talking to him, you know, whether it be conference calls or over at his house. So our game plan is and our strategies and our preparation is the same.
I think did he post yesterday at all?
Did he what?
Did he show up at all yesterday? I mean, yesterday.
No, we went to his house. We went to his house. I mean, we got home 3 o'clock in the morning, so it made no sense to try to get him here at 8 o'clock in the morning. We actually went out to his house, had breakfast, a couple of English muffins, and, you know, we talked a lot about, you know, finishing up, recapping the Creighton game and getting ready for Seton Hall.
How much more the preparation falls on you and maybe Brian and your shoulders more than normal? Is that, or has that changed at all?
Hasn't changed at all. We divide the scouts up between you know, the staff, myself, Brian, and Jeff Battle. So this scout was already done, you know, and as well as the Butler game and the Xavier game and the Villanova games, those are already being worked on now. So it's just about putting a practice plan together, how we're going to prepare, which we've done so many times that, you know, it's kind of a good routine that we're in. And the team's in a good place right now, so we're just trying to keep everybody confident. Hopefully we can, you know, do a little bit to try to get our offensive attack a little bit more solid this weekend.
You had, a couple instances when Coach Calhoun at UConn was out a little bit. How much maybe does that, when the coach goes down, that it falls on you guys? Just how much maybe those experiences maybe help you now a little bit?
I don't know. I don't know. You know, obviously the head coach is such a, you know, a big part of any program, and, you know, the kids are so used to their voice. I think, you know, the important thing is for us to, you know, just to maintain our consistent preparation and try not to let it be a distraction. And I don't think it was in the last game. You know, even though we didn't score the ball well and we played in a, you know, very hostile environment there at Creighton, I thought that the guys were pretty much still focused and everybody was, you know, pretty much dialed in. So our job when he's not here is just to make sure that things are normal as possible.
So maybe, like, the last thing is, he a game time decision for Saturday, Coach, or is he gonna post Saturday?
We fully expect him to be there. We fully expect him to, you know, be a part of the preparation going into the game. So we haven't even talked about anything else other than just our normal preparation for Seton Hall.
Toughest question. How many fans are going to watch the Patriots and not go to the Friar game?
I'm not sure. I think they said that they're going to put the Patriots game up on the Jumbotron. So if you want to come down, you know, I think that some of the plays will be called right there from, I think Belichick is going to be there.
Good.
So he's going to watch our game. So come on out. Make sure you come to the dump this weekend.
If you don't want to freeze in the cold.
No, yeah, it's cold out there. Yeah. You know, you can watch the game, get some popcorn, and watch the Friars go head to head.
Is Big East as physical as it is previous years as this year?
I think so.
Yeah.
You know, it's always a physical league.
Yeah.
You know, and we got a, I think it's talented, you know, and it's a lot of skill in it also. But, yeah, definitely it's physical because every game is going to come down to the wire, you know, on any given night.
So a 30-second shot clock, physicality makes a difference.
Yeah, yeah, and everybody's trying to throw it in. There's a bunch of big men that are good in this league. You know, we have, you know, Ben. You know, we're playing against a good one, a double-double guy this weekend in Delgado. You know, the two big guys from Marquette, you know, Georgetown is back, you know, banging, you know. So it's definitely, we still feel it's the toughest league, you know, in the country.
How was all this, doing all the media stuff and everything like that?
You know, it's, you know.
Doing the conference call today and dealing with us schleps.
You know, we say it to the players, you know, next man up.
Yep.
You know, of course, I'm not saying that with coach or anything, but, you know, we have to make sure that we give this team, you know, a chance to continue to be successful. So we're trying to keep it as normal and as business-like as possible.